So good afternoon to everyone present here. Today we will be celebrating IEEE Day 2021. So just a brief, what is IEEE Day? You might be thinking. So just a brief answer on that. IEEE Day is a celebration of engineers and IEEE members worldwide. So this year is the 12th consecutive year that IEEE is celebrating IEEE Day. And today, this week has been really great for IEEE, as there are many SBs conducting IEEE Day celebrations, ours being one of them. I believe some of our students have also attended other celebrations, and I hope you like them. Anyways, I would like to pass it over to our branch counselor, Dr. Sarika Chauhan, to say a few words. Then. Sarika ma'am, you can go.
Yeah. Good afternoon, everyone. So I, Dr. Sarika Chauhan, Chief Academic Officer of Department of IT, VSIT, as you all are aware, and the branch counselor of IEEE VSIT student branch and advisor of WI, that is Women's in Engineering at IEEE VSIT. Welcome you all to the IEEE Day celebration. As we all are part of IEEE, we would like you all also to join our community, our family, IEEE family. Aditya and Umkar, they have prepared one presentation giving you a brief about the IEEE benefits. There are many benefits of IEEE which are there. I'll just request everyone not to, you can say, go by what we are saying. You can just go explore the benefits at your own. And I have received the information, like many new students also have joined. Are they are also there in the meeting, Aditya? So I welcome them.
Yes,
also
ma'am.
So I welcome the new members also to our family, IEEE family. See, IEEE, it's an international organization, and if I'll say the benefits, it's really countless, right? Main benefits, if I'll say, IEEE gives you, you know, the technical upgradation or updation of whatever is happening in the world, because since it's an international organization, we can connect people internationally, right? We have Collaboratech, which is a community, the global community. We can connect with the people of your interest. If I'll talk about IEEE Explore is a library by IEEE, where a lot of articles, ebooks, research papers are available. A lot of resources are available, so you can freely access those resources. IEEE Spectrum, which is a magazine by IEEE, which gives you, you know, latest update in the technology, which is happening in all over the world. Very good articles are there. Very high quality articles are there. And as you must have heard about the IEEE standards, right? Many organizations are following the IEEE standards, rules and regulations laid down by IEEE. We have IEEE TV, IEEE app is there. Once you are a member of IEEE, you will get a free email ID or the personalized email ID. Like I have sarika.chauhan@IEEE.org. Free Google app, you can make use of. Simple, like you log in with your Gmail. Like that only you can log in with your IEEE personalized email ID. And not only this, there are a lot of funding opportunities which are available for the students. Those who wanted to avail the scholarships, they can avail those scholarships, especially if you want any travel grants for your studies, for your education abroad. The IEEE provides those facilities also to IEEE members. So I have just listed down very, very few, you can say, benefits of IEEE. So IEEE Day, actually we celebrate IEEE Day on every 5th of October is actually the IEEE Day, and this complete month we celebrate IEEE Day to celebrate IEEE members and what kind of, you know, the benefits IEEE provides. And not only that, but we celebrate being a member or being a part of this recognized, or you can say international organization, the recognized international organization provides lot many endless benefits to its members. So I must say, not only that, because I'm a branch counselor of IEEE, but IEEE really gives you a lot of benefits, and it's up to you to explore that. And I always say one dialogue, like, if you take one step, IEEE will take 9 steps. So wish you all the best. Wish you all a happy IEEE day once again. And without taking much of your time today to celebrate IEEE day, we have planned a lot of the workshop is there, other activities also we have planned, and even our students, they have prepared some, you can say, the presentations to make you aware about what IEEE offers to its members. So once again, welcome you all to IEEE Day celebration at our VSIT IEEE SB student branch. So over to you, Aditya.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, is my screen visible and am I visible?
Yes.
Okay, so I guess most of all are new students, which we did recruit in the membership drive. So most of you guys have just heard about these things, but just a refresher for the older students, the second years, the third years that have taken the IEEE membership. So these are the benefits of IEEE membership. So here's a little quick facts about IEEE. So the IEEE region 10, the R10 that we are in, it was founded in the year 1967. It has 58 sections, 34 subsections, and 6 councils. And with of those 58 sections, the Bombay section is one of them, which comes under the India Council. So it was founded in the year 1976. The India Council has 11 sections under it. So we are, as residents of India, a part of IEEE India Council. And going to the Bombay section, the section level, we belong to the Bombay section as our college is in Mumbai. So Bombay section consists of 3 states, Maharashtra, Chhattisgarh, and Goa. And it was also formed in 1976. It has above 120 student branches. So VSIT is one of the student branches that is in the Bombay section. And there are 13 societies and society chapters and affinity groups in Bombay section. So here's just a quick run through of the benefits of IEEE membership. You get technical content like the Explore Digital Library. You get the Spectrum magazines. You get access to multiple research papers through Explore. You get networking through the IEEE members member directory. So you can connect with people. You get collaborate tech access. So you can collaborate with other people if you have ideas. So careers and recognition and continuing education, that is kind of clubbed into one, where if you put IEEE, that you are a part of IEEE, in your resume, it adds weight. It adds a lot of weight to your resume, and it really helps you get to the next step in your career. There are member discounts. So the new members might know about the member discounts. There was a 50% off promotion going on recently for the IEEE membership itself. So we had to pay $27 in 2020, but the new members just had to pay $13.50. So the member discounts are, there are plenty of them. They are not just for IEEE. There are other discounts as well. There are humanitarian programs, one of them which we conducted yesterday, where our college, the IEEE core committee from our college, went to an organization where we taught kids of 9th and 10th standard about the importance of STEM. So there are humanitarian programs as well. And then there is one thing that I would like to mention that is not on this slide, which is the Google Apps access, which is really useful for a student like me, you, for all of us, as you know that the free Google Drive tier, which gives you about 15 gigabytes of space on Google Drive, gets filled up really quick. So if you need access to more storage, IEEE gives you access to 30 gigabytes of Google Drive space, and it gives you access to Google Meet with a 100 participant limit, and it does also offer other Google One subscription benefits. Ma'am, my presentation isn't moving forward. Hang on, I'll unshare and reshare just a moment. Okay. So as I mentioned before, there was the IEEE member digital library, there's the IEEE Explore library, and the Spectrum. So Spectrum is a magazine, a monthly magazine that you will receive in either your mail or like a physical copy at your home. IEEE Explore is a digital library, as Sarika ma'am said, that houses a lot of research papers. I believe it was 5.4 million something research papers. So coming out to professional networking, IEEE Collaboratech. Collaboratech will help you contact industry specialists in specific fields if you want more opportunities, if you want to learn. So Collaboratech is a really good tool. And the humanitarian programs, there is IEEE site, there's FX. As I said, there was a STEM event conducted yesterday by our WOI affinity group. So there are many humanitarian events taking place as well. So I apologize, my presentation is being a bit laggy. So what does IEEE bring you as for you as a student? What does it give you what does it do to enhance your student experience? It gives you access to conferences, workshops, events. It gives you access to IEEE TV, IEEE Explore, IEEE Collaboratech. It also gives you access to Google Apps, which are, I guess, a 300 to 400 rupees per month subscription, which you're getting for free with IEEE. So IEEE can give you a lot. And as ma'am said, and I really liked that quote, that if you take one step, IEEE will take the next 9 steps for you. So I really believe in that, and I have personally experienced that. So moving on to the WIA team, they would like to share a presentation of them as well. So WIA team, you there?
Yes, just a minute. We're just sharing the presentation. Can you hear my voice?
Yes, you're audible. You're not visible though.
Yeah. Good afternoon, everyone. Now I would like to talk about, I'm Priyadarshini Sawan, and I'm the chairperson of WI, Women in Engineering. Now I'd like to talk about what are the WI membership benefits. So before that, I would like to just talk about what is WI about. So IEEE Women in Engineering is a global network of IEEE members, and is dedicated to promoting women engineers and scientists and inspiring girls to around the world to follow their academic interests in career in engineering and science. Ruswan, can you go to the next slide? So our global network connects nearly 24,000 members in over 100 countries to advance women in technology at all points in their life and career. IEEE WI members make lifelong friends, so that you can make acquaintance and with other IEEE WI members, other affinity groups, and talk about your research, and you can get information, exchange information and ideas through WI. So this is IEEE WI by the numbers of 2019, like how many affinity groups have been made all over the world. So 900 plus IEEE WI affinity groups have been there in over 100 plus countries. If you can see, 46% is from India, China, and the Pacific Rim, and all over. 30% of our IEEE members are also men. So our mission is to facilitate the recruitment and retention of women in technical disciplines globally. We envision a vibrant community for IEEE women and men collectively using their diverse talents to innovate for the benefit of humanity. As you know, yesterday we conducted a humanitarian event for the kids of 9, 10, 10. So we, even through Vidya Alankar, IEEE affinity group, we do many humanitarian events also. So I would like to call Chetna Arya to talk more about IEEE.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Arya, and I am vice chair of IEEE WI affinity group. So now IEEE Women in Engineering not only is to recruit more women in technical discipline, but we also strive to provide assistance with the formation of new IEEE Women in Engineering affinity groups and support ongoing activities. We recognize the outstanding achievements of women in electrical and electronic engineering fields through IEEE awards and nominations, and organize workshops at major technical conferences to enhance networking and also to promote membership in IEEE WI. And also advocate women in leadership roles in IEEE governance and career achievement for women in technical profession. So we facilitate the development of programs and activities that promote the retention of more women in engineering programs, and also administer the IEEE student teacher and research engineer program to mentor young women in junior high and high schools. Yeah. So there are certain benefits and discounts which are provided for WI members, like discounted registration to IEEE WI events, networking opportunities are given, volunteering opportunities are there, and also certain WI awards and scholarships are granted. These scholarships are for WI members and WI affinity groups who have made contribution to the IEEE WI community by their involvement in projects and activities which are directed towards fulfilling these IEEE WI goals. Next slide, please. Yeah. And also certain travel grants are given to these WI members. For IEEE WI members to attend and present at IEEE sponsored conferences or IEEE WI sponsored events. So there's a link which if you want to know more info regarding the scholarships and grants which are given to the IEEE WI members will be given in the chat box. So now I would like to call upon Chetna to explain more about these.
Am I audible?
Yes, Chetna, carry on.
So, hello everyone, and I'm Chetna, the General Secretary of WI, and I'm going to speak on the grants and awards for WI members. One of the scholarship that is mentioned here is late Shri Hemant Sonawala Scholarship, which is given by the Hinditron group of companies for the most deserving undergraduate engineering world student who need financial support. And one of the award, which is late Shri Prahlad P. Chhabria, which is presented by Hope Foundation. So this is given to the best outgoing female student, like in the fields of STEM, like science, technology, and all. Next slide. So how to join IEEEWL? So for the members, for the people who are already the members of IEEE can log into their IEEE account and add the IEEEWI membership. And for the non-members, they can join as a professional or a student. And IEEEWI dues are $25 if you want to join only WI. And it is free for IEEE student, graduate student or life members, like if you take life membership. Next slide. So how to form student branch WI affinity group? So firstly,
we can just skip this, Shwetna. And I would just like to inform the other people. When you take IEEE membership, you people have to, you don't have to pay anything. You all just can simply, we can end this PPT now. Yeah. So if you have, because we have shown them all the benefits. Okay. So all the benefits and Chetna, if you can just brief them what kind of activity we do at IEEE VSIT, if you have that video and all, we can play those video. If we have that WIE and IEEE VSIT. Aditya or Chetna, if we can just show them. I think they have already seen also during our induction. But so I just wanted to tell everyone, like, you don't have to pay anything, not even a single penny. If you are taking a IEEE membership, WI membership, you just have to take, you just have to say that, okay, you wanted to take the WI membership. So automatically you will be a WI member. One more thing is very, very important. When we talk about, you know, WI membership, many people will feel like, especially boys, like WI is like women in engineering, so why should we be a part of this? And see, this is like to promote them. But to be very honest, even here, if you will see for WI, even yesterday, both the members, right, the full core committee, along with the boys and the girls, they have, you know, hosted yesterday's event. It was really, really good because it's a team, right? The event was for AXF students, so those who were the, like, for the NGO, AXF is an NGO, just to brief about 9th and 10th standard students about the importance of STEM. So all these, you know, the activities are also which we used to conduct, this free is there, then various technical activities we are conducting, so that we are not bounding, only girls can attend, okay? So everyone can be a part of this, everyone can avail this membership and be a part of WI events. So to end with this, I just wanted to tell you all, I think you must have got the gist of it, like the benefit of IEEE membership and benefit of, you can say, the WI membership. Maybe at the end, or if our video is ready, Aditya or Omkar, if we can just quickly show those short video. Are we ready with those video, if we can?
Yes, I'm ready to share.
Yes. So quickly, they will get to know. We have to given them the idea about what is IEEE, what is WI, but we have to just wanted to show you like what we are doing at IEEE VSIT SB and what we are doing at WIE. Okay. And then we will start our the other program. Students should not feel that motion. So we just wanted to give you an overview because we are getting a lot of queries from the students. About the IEEE membership or how to take the membership of WI. If somebody wants to being a member of WI, somebody wants to take a membership of IEEE. So we thought of starting this celebration with giving you some details about these two bodies and especially what we are doing at our IEEE. Are we
ma'am,
ready?
Just to add to what you said,
yes,
WI also gives you like a certificate, so you get a certificate that you were a member of WI from X date to Y date, and that will also help you in the future, as many companies now while recruiting, they do require some like work for an NGO or humanitarian work, which is WI is the humanitarian arm of IEEE, so that would also help you in the future. WI team, correct. Do you have your video ready? I'm having some issues sharing
correct.
Mine.
Correct, Aditya. So if anybody has that video, can we just quickly show? So we'll not waste time, or maybe we can run it at the end also. By the time technical team can keep those video ready, Omkar or Aditya. So, Chetna?
Yes, ma'am. We are finding the video. We can show it at the end.
Maybe by the time we can do one thing for the IEEE Day celebration, we need to click some pictures. So before the event itself, I request everyone to switch on their cameras and let's have a nice group picture for IEEE Day celebration. Are we all ready? Yes. So I request all the participants, if we can have a large gallery view, if you all can just join us to celebrate our IEEE Day. Yes, quickly, I request everyone to switch on their cameras if they can. Who is taking the picture? We'll take it a large gallery view.
Yes, ma'am. Guys, let's just turn your cameras on. It's just yes, for one please. Picture.
Yes, please join us, everyone. Celebration of IEEE Day. And I request, like, whoever can, like, I'm not joining from the Teams app, so I'm not able to change my background. But I can see Harsh, Aditya, Neeraj. Can you just share this background in the chat or somewhere?
Yes, ma'am.
Just so people can just change and if they can.
Yes, ma'am. Just.
Because I've joined from browser. So.
Aditya, am I audible?
Yes.
Yes, we can use our IEEE signature also.
Yes. Ready.
Yes.
So I request everyone because there are very few people have joined, and even our court committee also I can't see. Everyone has to switch on their cameras. Quickly, quickly. Come join everyone.
And as this is an AR event with Snapchat filters, you are going to have to turn your camera on at some point in this event. So yeah. Photo maybe aajao.
Please come fast, everyone. Then we have to start our event as well. I think you all are here for the event. Sure. Okay. So we'll see IEEE.
Yes, we'll do this sign and we'll say IEEE. 1, 2, 3, IEEE. Is it done?
Yeah, I've taken pictures. Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you so much, guys.
Thank you so much, guys.
Everyone. And at the end, team, I would like you all to keep that IEEE Day background, okay? And we'll have we'll click the picture only with that those who have the IEEE background for submission of that photo contest, okay? So over to you, Aditya. Let's start with our event.
Yes, ma'am. So just before I start, I would like to call upon Harsh to give a short introduction of what we are going to do. But before I do that, I would like to send a link in the chat box. So everyone who's here, I please request you to just download this Lens Studio app from Snapchat. I have given the link in the chat box. Get it installed. And
yeah, am I audible and visible?
Yes, you are.
All right. Good afternoon to everyone present here today. I hope you're having a great day. I'm Harsh from IEEE VSIT Student Branch. I'm the Membership Development Head. And today, the IEEE VSIT Student Branch has organized a small workshop on AR filters on Snapchat. I've seen a couple of you already on Snapchat. I've said hi to you all. Good to talk to you all. Our speakers for tonight, Omkar and Aditya, will teach you things about augmented reality filters and how you can use those filters and create them. After you create one of these filters, you will receive a certificate in your email. And after the event, as part of the IEEE Day celebration, we've planned a fun activity for you to interact with the IEEE committee. So let me not take any more of your time and call upon Omkar Tavte, our GS, General Secretary for IEEE VSIT, to start with today's event.
Hello guys, you can hear me, right?
Yes, you're audible and visible.
Yeah, so good afternoon each and everyone present over here today. I, Omkar Tavte, General Secretary of IEEE VSIT. I will give you some information on what is AR and why we use AR and how can we make one. So before talking about AR, we'll just see the history of AR. Over the last 50 years, augmented reality technology was reshaped the way we consume content in the real world. Augmented reality technology was invented in 1968 with Ivan Sutherland developments of the first head-mounted display system. However, the term augmented reality wasn't coined until 1990 by Boeing researcher Tim Caudle. So in 1999, NASA created a hybrid synthetic vision system of their X-38 spacecraft. The system leveraged AR technology to assist in providing better navigation during their test flights. So what is the future of augmented reality? As we became increasingly dependent on our mobile devices, the adoption of augmented reality technology is on its race. AR software advances will be the way forward as overwhelming majority of consumers have a smartphone and already take it everywhere with them, making it a convenient medium to bring AR nearly to every consumer. The truth is, augmented reality is already used by everyday consumers. They just don't know it. AR still seems to be misconstrued as too high tech for your average Joe. But the Snapchat dog filter and other powered AR, the biggest shift in augmented reality. We will have to be how it's delivered to change the perception. So now we have talked about the dog filter of Snapchat. So let's go on Snapchat. Snapchat is one of the most widely used social media platforms in the world. The site has over 360 million active monthly users as of January 2020, with 3 billion snaps generated every day. How did Snapchat grow so large in such a short period of time? Snapchat is one of the leading social media platforms in the world in 2020, and it's not even 10 years old. Here's a deep dive into the company's history and why Snapchat as a company at least showed no sign of disappearing. Now, let's talk about its early history. Snapchat was founded in 2011 by Evan Spiegel, Reggie Brown, and Bobby Murphy, all students at Stanford University. Reportedly, Brown came up with the idea of social media app that enabled user to post photos and videos that disappeared from their site after a few moments. Snapchat Lens was an instant hit among users after their in-house team built more than 3,000 AR filters. They have launched a free desktop app called Lens Studio in December 2017 that can help both average users and advertisers to bring their creations to life. 2 years later, they have announced the 2.0 version that can transform pets, hands, bodies, and iconic landmarks around the world with the power of augmented reality. And now, with this power that we have, we will create some interesting filters using Snapchat Lens Studio, and we will also post them on Snapchat. But before that, I would request you guys to make filters with us. And if you have any doubts, just type it in the chat box and I will clear them out. Or you can raise your hands and you can ask your doubts. So now I request Aditya Saraf to take forward this event by showing them how to make filters. Thank you guys.
So, okay, before I begin, I just want to know how many of y'all have installed Lens Studio by now. I have given the link in the chat box. You just have to download it and install it. It's not that big of a file. Please raise your hand if you have installed it. Okay, there's one so far. Three. Other people just get on it, install the software. We'll take a 5-minute break and let's just get their software installed by then, and we'll start in 5 minutes.
I don't think we can access chat.
Okay, hang on. I've also sent it on the IEEE students group chat, so you could check that as well. So we will continue this by 3:50, 3:52. Just get the software installed and then we'll start as soon as most of you all get it installed.
I've joined using mobile phone, so it's not gonna be installed on here.
It's okay, you can just watch what we're doing and maybe recreate it later.
Okay.
Mubashara, it's okay if you don't have a webcam. You can just create the filters on your laptop and import them to your phone. So, like, it's not an issue if you don't have a webcam. You just won't see a live preview. But that won't be that big of an issue.
I guess all of them are downloading right now.
Yeah, let's wait till 52 and we can start by 352.
Yeah, okay, sure.
Just make sure you download it. You do not need an account on Snapchat to download it. You can just access it without an account. Okay, so let's just start by now. Anyone who's still downloading, you can download and go through this like with us. I'm going to be going slow as to like let you all catch up. So don't worry if you have any doubts, just unmute and ask. So once you open the Lens Studio, it will look something like this. And for now, just I know there's a lot of things on your screen. So just for now, just go to the search bar, and the first filter we're going to be making is just a simple one of a baseball cap. So just search for a baseball cap in the search bar and it should pop up. So I will be giving you a guide of the project screen right here. So that's me on the right. So this right here is the live display, like the preview screen of the filter. This is what it would look like in the app. The window up on here, over here, is the objects. So this is where you can add objects, like you can add lights, you can add like images or like entities like the hat or the face paint right here. So there's the objects here, the resources. So this text is stored in the resources. If you want to import an image, for example, that would be stored in the resources. So that's the resources panel. This right here, this you do not need to worry about for now, as this is just the scene configurator. And this would just be a bit too confusing for you guys for now. But once you click on an object, you can see in this inspector window, you'll see multiple like attributes for it. So don't worry, these are like, this might seem a little bit complex for now, but it's really easy and you don't need to like be afraid of what's going on. So I'll guide you through everything. So first thing when you see after you open this is this this screen right here. So for now, I'm just going to be as simple as possible, as this is your first filter you're making. So for example, if I want to change the color of my hat right here, like the baseball hat, so I will go to the baseball cap controller right here in the objects pane. And you can see there are two primary and secondary cap colors. So you can change those to anything you like. For now, I'm just going to do white and blue. So they are the IEEE colors. So there's a white and blue hat. I can change the color of my face paint right here. So that is down here in the face paint section. So over here, I'll just do that as white and blue as well. You can give the RGB values if you know what that is, or you can just use this color picker from here. So here I have that. And in the end, you can change this image up top, which says yay. So for now, I'm just going to use an IEEE logo. So it fits with the theme, with the IEEE theme. So like a blue IEEE shirt, a blue IEEE hat. So from over here on the resources panel, there is this plus icon where you can add a file. So this is where you have to go from files and you have to locate an image that is on your laptop. So download a PNG image or a JPEG is also fine for something like this, but I would recommend a PNG or a GIF. So you can use animated pictures, but yeah, just import it like that. And once you have it, you can see it over here. This is the IEEE logo. And if I go onto the baseball cap controller and over the logo texture, so this is where you can just go over here and select the IEEE logo. So I just made a filter with IEEE themed face paint and an IEEE hat. It was that easy. And if you want to use it on Snapchat, on top, on the top right, there is a button called preview in Snapchat. So if you have the Snapchat app, you can click on that and just scan that using your phone. I'll do that over here. So after you do that, it'll pair with your Lens Studio. So any life changes you make here will be visible on your phone as well. So Mubashira, I think that was your issue. Okay, you didn't have a webcam. So you can just pair your phone to it and use your phone to see the live changes. So just a moment here. And once you have paired it to Snapchat, you can just click on send to Snapchat and it just sends the filter over to your phone. So you don't even have to scan the code again and again. So here I have taken a picture using the same IEEE filter. Okay, it's putting the filter on top of the filter. So that's some filterception right there. But you can easily use those filters on your Snapchat app as well. So there is your first filter. If anyone has any doubts, you can just unmute yourself or ask them in the chat. Do you want me to go slow? Do you want me to repeat something? Do you want me to like start over again? I'm willing to do that if anyone is like doing it with me.
I'm not finding the search button.
Your voice cut out. Could you repeat that?
I'm not finding the search button for me to search the baseball hat.
Okay, hang on. So we have to make the same cap? No, you can make anything you like. So you can make it about a show you like. So get a logo of your show. Like if I personally like Brooklyn Nine-Nine a lot. So I could get the B99 logo and put it on there and put something like a police color. So like it would be black and blue kind of. So that would kind of fit the aesthetic. So you can do anything. I'm just doing IEEE as it is IEEE Day celebration today. Saib, you're unable to find the search box, right?
Yeah.
Is that? Yeah, so let me just save this. So what can you see right now? Is this what you see?
Yeah.
So just go up here and search for baseball cap. And that should give you what you're looking for. If you want me to go over it again, I can. So just let me know. So for the people trying with me, I am giving you some time. I'm giving you 10 minutes. I'm giving you 5 to 10 minutes. You can do it and you just send a picture in the chat box, or you could tag me on Snapchat if you have me on Snapchat. So it's up to you on how you want to share it, but I'm giving you 10 minutes. You have to like at least try to do something unique. So does anyone have any doubts so far in session?
So Aditya?
Yes.
Could you repeat the process, because I just downloaded it, installed it.
Yeah, sure. So once you open it, once you open Lens Studio, it should look something like this, right?
Yes.
So go to the search bar and search for baseball cap. That's the first template we're using for the day. And click on it. So do you want me to go through the windows again, or did you like get that part? I'll just go over them again, just in case you didn't get them. So the left window right here, where you see my pretty face, is the preview panel. The one beside it is the inspector. So this is where you change attributes of different things. So right here, I don't have anything selected. So if I select the baseball cap, it will come up with attributes. So in this selection view, you don't really have to like do anything for now, as that is for more advanced 3D modeling stuff. So we are not going to go into that too much for today. So just know that this is something you can use in the future for 3D modeling. So the part on the bottom is the logger, which is basically stores any errors that the filter might like detect. So if there are any errors, if there is like something failed to load in, it will show in the logger. Then there is this section right here, which is the resources. If you like edit photos or videos, this is like the resources window over there, where you can import folders. So if you have a folder on your desktop where you have images that you want on your filter, so you can have that over here for easy access. And the top left is the object section. So this is where you have your lighting, you have your camera, and you have like everything from the face paint to the baseball cap. So to edit this in a simple way, right now, the first thing I did was just to change the colors. So click on the baseball cap controller, and you can see in the inspector section, there are two like attributes over there for the cap, the primary cap color and the secondary cap color, which are the top cap and the bottom cap color respectively. So you can change that to anything you like. So I'm just going to do a different one for now, as I already did the IEEE one. You can also change the face paint you have on. So these two streaks on your like under your eyes, you can change the color of that. You can change the shape of that as well, but I will go into that a bit later. So If you want to change the logo up here on the top, which says yay, there are some logos that are like like in the template itself, there is like an animated GIF of a cat, for example. There is like wow, yay, and a sheep. So if you want to use those, you can use those, or you can click the plus button right here and choose from files. So if you click on that, you can just go in here and just like pick a file. Just a moment. So it does get imported right here. This is the IEEE Day one I found on my PC. So you can use any image, you can use a show, an anime you like, a game you like. So to edit the image on top, all you have to do is click on the baseball cap controller again. And under logo, there should be a logo texture field. And over that, if you click on the field right there, you can change it and select the one you want. So here's an IEEE Day hat that is animated as well. So it's a GIF. You can use GIFs, you can use images. I would preferably you should use PNGs, but if you want something animated, you can use GIFs as well. And the process of sending it to Snapchat is just on the top right, you can see pair Snapchat or send to Snapchat. And that will give you a code that you have to scan using your phone. And once you scan that, you can just open the Snapchat app and click on send to Snapchat. And it will just appear on your Snapchat app just like that. So here is, hang on. Yep. Here you can see, I'm not sure if that's visible, but that filter is visible on my Snapchat app right now. So I can take pictures using it. It's the old filter that I'm using over here because I haven't sent the new one. But yeah, it works. If you just send it again, it will update it on the app as well.
Aditya?
Yes?
We have to work only on this particular filter right now, or can I choose some other template as well?
For now, just take the baseball cap one because it is one of the easiest to work on. We are planning to go on to like advanced ones. So for your first one, I was like, okay, let's just pick an easy one as this is like pretty simple to create. We will be like, I will be teaching you how to create one from scratch as well. So look forward to that. So without using any templates, we will be creating our last filter, which is a crown, like a text crown filter. So if anyone's performing with me, you could just post the screenshots in the chat. Even if you're not done, just post a screenshot of your workspace. So I'll know that like at least someone is working with me. Okay, Athira and Atharva are doing it. I'll wait till 4:15 and we'll move on to the next filter by then. By that time, if you have any doubts, you could just ask me.
From where can you access the size of the cab?
Size of what?
Size of the cab.
The size of the cab is, it should automatically fit to your face. If it's not, I will show you how to adjust the size. Problem. Yeah, hang on. So do not touch this if your like cap is already like fitting. If it does not fit you, then go into camera under head and you'll see like baseball cap script properties. So in here, there should be a transform function. So over here, there is a scale function. So if you scale it up a little bit, so that increases the size of the cap. So if you can see, it's getting bigger. So I would not recommend to doing this if your like cap is fitting, or if like even if it's a little bit off, try not to scale it, as it can cause problems loading on your phone. As like if you scale it too much, it will go out of your screen. So that might cause issues in the future. So if you want to scale it, just I would recommend keep the values between like 1 and 2 or like 0 and 2. So there's that if you want to resize it. And if you want to just try it in another way, so like if that's not working for you, go to like the baseball cap controller and you can try like getting the scaling up here as well. But I would seriously not recommend messing with the scaling unless like it's really not fitting. So there are multiple like face paint options. I will let you know about these in the next template that we pick up. So I think that was Jawad, right? With the doubt. Does that fix your doubt?
No, I'm trying to increase the scale, but the size is the same.
Okay.
So how can we use gradient colors?
The gradient colors is the next filter, so I'll let you know in the next filter.
Okay.
So I think we should begin with the second filter by now. So you should just see the distort template on your home screen. If you're in a project, You can save the project from the file menu or by pressing Control S. That will save the project. And you can head back to the Lens Studio home screen by hitting this home button on the top left. So that gets you back to the main splash screen of the Lens Studio. So for the second filter for today, we are going to use the distort template. So we have already done like a 3D template so far. So now we're gonna do like something funny, something like goofy. So this is something that I personally use when I'm sending streaks. So if you want to send streaks and you want to be like, oh, hey, this is a filter I created. So you can use this. So distort by default, it is like a really good filter in itself, but you can like tweak a lot of things in here. So you can add specular lighting to it. You can add like lots of like other face stretch aspects to it. So I can just have my nose like really tiny. And if I have my mouth be like a weird shape. So this is like a perfect, I guess, streak sending filter. So over here, we are actually, I'm using these face stretch, like this is a mesh. So this is a face stretch mesh. So we are using this to basically map points on your face. And those points are then like stretched and they create like a really funny result. I'm not sure if you can see me in the preview window there, but this does look like a lot crazier than like the default distort filters that are available on Snapchat. So if you want to scare someone using a filter, so this is a really good idea. So you can just play around with these like mappings a little bit. I can make myself look like ET if I want to. So and the another thing I would like to make another concept that I would like to use in this filter is like another type of object you can add. So we are adding post filters, so like post effects. So you know how in some Snapchat filters, it's not like a face filter, it's not like a lens. It's just the color gets changed a little bit, or you can see like a 3D image, like you see in like movie theaters. So that is what post effects does. And Saib, you can do gradients from here, from post effects. So the first post effect I would like to use is the distortion one, because it's honestly the funniest one. So it basically turns me into liquid, and this basically takes the distortion filter to a whole another level. You can add the like another texture for the wave. So this is the, hang on, I'll show you the wave texture for now. So this is what the wave texture looks like on the bottom. But if you have any other wave textures with you, you can get textures from Paint 3D. So if you just search for Paint 3D, you can look for like textures right here. So new, there are like different textures. There's like matte, gloss, metal, like dull and polished metal. So you can get textures just from this, like just get this, paint it however you want, and just put in spots of like a different color. So if I just save this as a PNG or a JPG, I will be able to use this as a texture map. And make this effect even more crazy. So if I want to tone it a bit down, I could just a moment here. Sorry for that. So if you want to just edit it a little bit, you can just over here in the inspector for the distortion, there is an attribute. So you can just from 4, you can put it to 2 if you want it to be less crazy. So like it's still like distorting everything around me, but not as much. So I think 2.5 would be like a really sweet spot, but I would just like it to be a little bit more crazy. So there's your distortion filter. This is like a perfect filter for streaks. For the next filter, we're going to be using, we're going to be doing it from scratch. So I think Jawad has already, yeah. Big brain. But yeah, Jawad has already posted 2 screenshots. So that's great. For the next filter, we're going to be doing it from scratch, not using a template. So let me just save this. And go back to the home screen. So for the third one, we are just going to use a normal, like a blank project. We are not using a template. So just click on new project. This is the first time you're going to be using the new project button. So there's me all normal again. So for this one, I'm just going to put a crown, so a text crown. So if you're not sure what that is, it will just show up a text on top of here. So you need to get an image, so a PNG image. I'm not sure if I have one on hand right now, so I'm just going to use the IEEE logo for now as my crown. But hang on. So I just imported the image in the resources. So the first thing I would do is add a new object. So objects are what we have been messing with for now. So like the templates already had the objects that we were using. But now we are adding our own objects. We are adding like, I believe we are doing 2 this time. So under objects, you click plus, and if you add a face effect, you can see a face image object. So add that one for now. That adds a missing image picture right here. But if I go into the inspector and for the texture, I choose the IEEE logo. There you go. There's the IEEE logo on my nose, but I want it on my forehead. So I will just stretch it up and get it up onto my forehead. It's that simple. So this is the first time you're using the scene window. So this is just for 2D. This was the 3D one we were seeing previously. But if you click on view 2D scene, you can just like assign an image anywhere you want. So just a moment. And if you like drag and drop this middle like pointer anywhere, that will basically act as an anchor. So if you want, so right here, if my for now the anchor is just like at the center, so it doesn't really like change its angle. But if I want IEEE to like change an angle, so I would just change it to like right here. So you can see how it like goes up when I look up. So that's where like the pivot anchors come into play. So you can just place it anywhere you want. But I, for now, I would just like it to be on the bottom as the logo is above my head. And the thing that honestly will like look better is like if you move it above and have the anchor just like touching your forehead. So that's like a actual crown. It's in the air, not on my face, but it's still attached to my face in a way. So the second thing is I would like to show you like some other post effects. So I would like to add, so for that we would add an object. We would go to general, and over there is the post effects option again. So for this, I'm using analog TV. So Saib, here is where you would select the color gradient, but I'm selecting an analog TV for now. So that would add another like filter, like a non-face filter. So this is just adding a bit of distortion to just create a vibe. So this, I believe this filter is used a lot on Instagram nowadays. So I've seen a lot of it on Instagram. So you can just use this. And if you want to change it a little bit, you can just go into the textures and change these attributes a little bit. But I feel like this is like perfect. But if you do change these attributes, you can increase like the instance counts. So if I do it 5, there's like a 5 polygon, like a 3D effect going on. I'll just make this bigger. So you can see there's the like chromatic aberration style lighting going on right here. But if I go back to 1, it's like toned down a little. You can increase or decrease the intensity of like the noise. So this is a lot more noisier. This gives off like more retro 70s, like late 70s color TV vibes. Or you could tone it down a little for like a 90s vibe. And the chromatic aberration, there is another slider for that. So if you just go down to 0, it's a normal image. But if you turn it up, the chromatic aberration goes up again. And there is a bit of distortion associated with this analog TV post effect. But it's more of like, if you've had an analog TV, like a CRT TV, if you just like take a magnet and put it close to a TV, you know how it distorts. Like it either goes all wide like this or all tall like this. So it's for that, and that is an aesthetic. So if you want to try that out, you can. So you can just try everything out for now, and you can mess with other like post effect filters. You can mess with VFX, but I would recommend you not to use VFX as of now, because they are very like graphically intensive. So if you have a machine that is like not strong enough, it will like cause Lens Studio to crash. So I would like be on the safer side and not use VFX for now. I would just recommend you all to just go through like the face effects. There is a face liquefy, there is a face mask. So for face mask, you can use an image that is like a 3D image, so an OBJ file or an FTX file, I believe. So if you use those files, you can use like, you can map an Iron Man helmet on your head. But yeah, that's pretty much it for this filter as well. But this is another filter that we did from scratch. So we didn't use any templates for this one. And I hope you guys are trying with me as well. So everyone who's trying, just put like screenshots, or just put like, if you are trying, just put I am trying in the chat box, or like raise your hands or something. Okay, there are people trying. Yes.
Can you show how you put that analog TV filter again?
Yeah, just a moment. So let me just remove it. So in objects, you go to general, and under general, there should be a post effects section. So you can add a lot of things right here. So like color correction. So you know those filters where like the reds are boosted up a little bit. So like your lips look pink, and like the greens and blues are toned down a little. So that is where the color correction happens. And that is where you have the analog TV option as well. So if you click on that, it will add the effect. And if you just click on, hang on just a moment right here. If you click on the resource for analog TV, you can change like the instance counts, the depth functions. The depth functions are, they are like really crazy to mess with, so they can lead to like varying results. So I would not mess with those unless like you know what you're doing. But the noise and chromatic aberration intensity can be adjusted here. The distortion intensity can be adjusted here as well. Okay, Anita is also performing with us. Okay, so I'll be waiting on any doubts or like completed filters till 4:40, and then we have a short game for you guys. It will be fun, and let's just wait for your filters. Let's see how creative you can get. So I'm giving you 10 minutes. I'm waiting till 4:45. Till then, post things in the chat box. And if we like your filters enough, if Sarika ma'am likes them enough, you might even get some IEEE goodies. Okay, Kimaya has a doubt. How did you add the resource image on face image? Okay, so I'll show you that. So let me just add the face image object right here. And once I add the face image, I click on image one. I add the resource using like the resources panel right here has a plus icon. Click on that. You click from files and then you select a file from your like laptop or desktop. So select a file from your hard drive. And it's having some issues. Let me just try again. Okay, that worked. So there's the IEEE logo. And once you do that, click on image one again. Click on texture. And on texture, you'll see like the default image, which is the broken image thing. So if you click on that, you'll see like a list of resources you have here and you'll find the image you selected basically. And then you can drag and scale like just like you would on like any other like mobile app or something. And then about anchor points, there are anchor points, like the center dot right here is an anchor point. So this is where the like logo will pivot from. So for now, it's just like poking straight out. So if I look up, it'll go up. If I look down, it'll go down. So if I select it to be right here, then it'll be like this, like it'll point upwards. So if I look up, it'll go up more than like the default option. And if I look down, it won't go down as much. So that depends on like what filter you're using. But if you're using like a crown, it is safe to like just have it on the bottom like bound of the image, as that is like a safe bet to have the anchor point on. Are there any other doubts? Please don't hesitate. This session is just for you. And this is supposed to be like a celebration. This is supposed to be a workshop that is hands-on. So like if you have any doubts, anything, you could just hit me up on here, unmute chat box. You could text me on WhatsApp. So yeah, just let me know if you have any doubts. I'll be glad to solve them. Don't hesitate to reach out. How do you get rid of the white background while importing an image? Atharva, try using a PNG image. So if you might be using a JPG, so that doesn't have like a background transparency property. If you search for PNGs on Google, you'll find PNGs and they will just have a transparency property to them. So if you just, it'll be drag and drop. Can I just rename the file? No, it unfortunately doesn't work that way. You could send it to me and I could convert it into a PNG if you want.
Aditya.
Yes, Jawad.
Can we insert some text which will follow our head around?
Yeah, but we'll have to do it through like an image. So hang on, I'll send you a website where you can make cool text. Okay. So this is a website where you can basically type in something and download a PNG for it. So it's really useful if you are doing like work on like anything like this, if you're working on like video editing or something, or even if you're working on websites. So there are like tons of fonts on here. There are, I believe, 150 or so fonts on there. And you can just type it and it'll give you a PNG.
Recording upload
over. Recording will be uploaded on our YouTube channel, so I'll let you know when it's uploaded. Group pe aa jayega link, so don't worry about that. And recording bhi agar aapko dekhna nahi hai, so you could just text me, you could call me, and doubts honge to I'll solve it.
Thank you.
Okay, so it's almost 4:50. Neeraj, are we ready with the game that we have planned for them? So we have like a short game slash activity planned for you guys. So it is ready. So filters, abhi banana zara chhod dijiye, and come back to the meeting. There will be a link posted in the chat box for a fun activity. We're gonna be celebrating IEEE Day through this activity. I want to keep it a surprise, but I'm not saying anything. So now the link has come. It's Scribble.io, which is basically Pictionary. So it's a game where you have to draw things and the others have to guess if you're not aware of what Pictionary is. So just click on that link and you'll be able to join.
Click on the link and you'll be able to join the lobby. And preferably have your name as like the username so we can figure out who won.
Yeah.
You have to join a private room?
Yes, it's a private lobby. Yes.
It's a private lobby, but you should just be able to like put your name in and click on play and you'll join the lobby.
Are you guys having difficulty connecting? Because I can see a few of you disconnecting from the lobby. Okay, Atharva, can you just quit and click on the link again?
Yeah, try leaving and rejoining.
Yeah, there's a link in the chat. I'll send it again, just in case. Yeah, so yeah,
is everyone
so
able to join?
If you're getting in with the random people, just leave a new link that has been sent. So it might be the link expired.
I guess there are random people on the link. I just joined and I can directly play the game. That's fine.
What are they?
Yeah, hang on. I think Neeraj, Adef, like max amount of people, like 12 people in the room.
Yeah, in this one, okay. There are max 12. So maybe there's a limit.
So yeah, there's a limit. I'm creating another room. So yeah, you guys will have to join mine.
Yeah, so the people who are in the this lobby with me, don't leave.
Yeah, so the people who are in the lobby with Neeraj, just stay there, play the game there.
There are two slots available, so two people can just click the link again to come back to the lobby.
And if
now it's full. So now you will have to join Aditya's lobby.
Yeah, so now join my lobby. If you are like trying to join, as like Neeraj's lobby is full. There are four slots empty for my link. If anyone wants to join, they can join.
Yeah, and there's one more slot in my lobby as well. I guess someone got disconnected.
Okay.
We'll be starting at 54, so you have 2 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
So just a heads up, all these words are IEEE and technology related. So
yeah, they're mostly technology related, not exactly IEEE related, but yeah, guess accordingly and good luck. May the best drawer and guesser win. I have 12 people in my lobby. I'm starting my game right now.
Yeah, so I'll start as well.
So just a refresher for like whoever hasn't played. On the right, there's like a chat box where you have to type your guesses and people will be drawing words. And you have to guess what they're drawing. And just for the drawers, you cannot draw, like you cannot write letters.
Where's the chat box?
It should be on the right. Are you on your phone, Maba?
No.
Then it might be at the bottom. Like scroll down.
Once again, a reminder, all words are technology related. So it can't be a door. at the top of the screen, you'll be like able to see the amount of alphabets. Okay, so that would help you in guessing.
I can't see the chat box.
What?
I'm leaving.
Just scroll down. Just scroll down. You can see the chat box there.
Yeah, just on try leaving and rejoining
maybe. No, I can.
Also, guys, just to make it challenging, try to pick different options, like some options that haven't been selected before. Okay, anyways, I hope you guys had fun. I would like to call in Rudraksh for just a little thank you and goodbye. There will be a feedback form posted in the chat box. I hope you guys are supposed to fill that up. I hope you do that right now. And yeah, Rudraksh, you there?
Yeah. I hope I'm both audible and visible.
Yes, you are.
Yeah. So first of all, I would like to thank Aditya and Omkar for such an amazing workshop as well as the activity. So I hope you hope everyone enjoyed this session and, you know, enjoyed this session and learned something new and something interesting today. So this was just the beginning of our events of IEEE 2021-2022. So we have a lot of events lined up. So if you want to be part of such events, I really urge everyone to be a part of IEEE. And I welcome each and everyone here to be a part of IEEE. And I congratulate everyone who has become a new member. And you know, I hope everyone will be present for all the further events. And also, if you want to check out our previous events that we have organized, we have a really interesting social media presence. And we have an active Instagram page. So I'll just post the Instagram page link in the chat. And do check it out and do follow and do share and do like the posts. So I hope you enjoyed the session. And I hope to see you all in all the further events. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Radaksh. A reminder for everyone, feedback form fill karke leave karna hai meeting. Number one. And if you found this interesting, tell your friends about IEEE, tell your friends to join, because this was just the start. As Rudraksh said, we have so many events planned, and this was just one handled by us. There are industry experts that are coming in. Rudraksh has posted the link for the Instagram page of IEEE VSIT. Drop us a follow on there to like stay updated on the latest events. Like, wahan pe exclusive quizzes bhi aate hain kabhi kabhi. So just drop us a follow on there, and if you have filled the feedback form, you can leave the link, you can leave the meeting.
Thank you
so much, Arman, and thank you so much to everyone who interacted. This session was really good. Mubah, your voice cut out.
Thank you,
Mubah.
And guys, fill the feedback form as you will get your certificates by filling it.
Yeah, you'll get your certificates after you fill the feedback form. So just make sure you fill it. And yeah, before leaving the meeting, just fill the feedback form. Just get it over with.
Once you guys have filled your forms, you can leave the session.